Hello there, my name is Chris Palmer, and in today's Google My Business Tips and Tricks tutorial, I want to share with you multiple Google My Business tips in order for you to easily find your customer ID because Google has changed the way the source code is presented. Along with that, I'll share with you Google My Business tools for knowledge graph to get the hexadecimal, semi-decimal. You'll also be able to find your CID easily. I'll also show you in this tips and tricks video on how you can find your competitors' categories. And along with that, I'll give you some other Google My Business helpful tips. So let's kick this off. I don't want to waste any time. Let me share with you the new way to find your customer identification number within Google. Now, please note, every business has issued this. So let me go ahead and share that with you now because they have changed the source code. And then I'll also share with you an easy to use tool. So first and foremost, if you want to find it the manual way, here is the new way to do that. So first and foremost, you will want to go to google.com, and I am using Google Chrome for this tutorial. If you're using another browser, unfortunately, I'm not. So let me just share with you how to do it on Google Chrome. So first and foremost, go to google.com. You'll be presented with a screen that looks much like this. Might be a little different. The next thing that you'll want to do is type in your business name. All right. For this particular example, I'm going to go ahead and use my own business name. Once this pops up, you're going to see your business name. Your website will probably be at the top. You will want to see this small bar here. Click on Maps. Now, it's automatically going to fill in your business name because that was your primary search. Now, once inside of here, the next element is inside of this white piece, as you can see here. You will want to right-click on your mouse and click on View Page Source. Again, I'm using Google Chrome. So once inside of the source code, you used to be able to search for hashtag LRD, right? You would hit Control F or Control Find and then look for hashtag LRD. That no longer works. Now, you also used to be able to do along the same lines, what you would type in is Control F or Control Find, and then you would type in Ludo CID. And generally right in here, what there would be is that hashtag LRD. And what would be here would be your actual customer identification number. Now, they've actually made it a little bit easier to find, even though I was asked to do this video to share this with you. Let me go ahead and share with you how easy it is. So now that you have the very first Ludo CID, if you look directly to the right of that, there's going to be a string. It'll say U, there'll be the letter U and some numbers. Right after the letter, all right, the first letter after the U003D here on my end, yours might be different. It might say like U004 or 001. It might be different, but it's always right to the very first one to the right is going to be your customer identification number. So if you go here and just go all the way to the first letter, what you're going to see here is your customer identification number. All right. Now, let me share with you a quick and helpful tip and tool that is going to allow you to find certain particular details a lot faster. So if you come back to Google Maps, all right, what you'll want to do is type in your business name. And once you type in your business name, a URL up in the URL field is going to be broadcasted across the screen. A very long, it'll contain longitude and latitude details along with browser details, right? So what you will want to do is copy that entire string and go over to plepr.com. No, I'm not affiliated. I just really like this tool. It's quite helpful. So what you'll want to do is head up to the very top where it says tools. Click on tools. You don't need an account. They allow you to utilize their tool set, complimentary, free. There's other tools that do this. I just want to share this with you. Click on the CID converter tool. All right. Now, once inside of here, what you're going to find is your CID or link to maps. Just go ahead and paste in that entire URL string and then click on the button that says convert and generate. Now, what's going to be converted and generated is going to be a magnitude of different things. Let me share that with you now. If we scroll on down, you will see your CID decimal. So again, that's that number that we found inside of here. When we right-clicked, went to view page source, we hit Control F, typed in Ludo CID. Remember that first one to the right here, all these numbers here, how I showed you how to do it manually? This tool will go ahead and just pull that code right back out of here. So here's the CID hexadecimal. Depending on what you're doing, you might want the hexadecimal version. But if you take a look right down here, URL to Google Maps, here's your CID, your customer identification. So this will actually, if people search this or say you have it on your website, it'll launch this particular page here. But along with that, they're adding in some extra details. If you take a look here, they're generating a URL to your knowledge graph panel, all right? And this is containing your CID here, all right? And then also you can report a problem. But what I want to share with you is they'll give you the embed code. They're giving you embed code for Google Maps plus the styling. They're giving you a lot of little helpful tips, all right? And I'm glad I could share that with you. Let's move on to the next tip, which is going to be another machine code called the machine-readable entity ID. Yes, I've shared this in another video, but I wanted to go ahead and recap this video, these tips and tricks again for you. But let me go ahead and share with you how you find the machine-readable entity ID. This is very, very useful for machine code stringing. Perhaps you're creating URLs to send links to. Perhaps you're embedding these. Perhaps you're just sharing these online or on your website. Let me go ahead and share with you how you can find your Google My Business machine-readable entity ID. Every business, every place has an entity ID. Where I'll also show you how you can find your place ID next. But let me share with you the machine readable entity ID now. So again, we will go to Google. I'll start from the very beginning so you can follow along. You will want to type in your business name. So for me, it's Chris Palmer Marketing. Once on Chris Palmer Marketing, you'll see this bar here. As you can see, it's up top here. You will want to click on the Maps tab. So I'll go ahead and click on that. That's Maps. Once Maps pops up, you'll want to click on this white space, right click. When you right click, you'll view the page source. Once on the page source page, it will look like this. You will want to go ahead and do Control F, that's Control Find, and you will want to type in /G/. This number right here after the /G/, this is your machine readable entity ID. All right, so this is great to add in to your knowledge graph link. If you're doing machine code stringing, you can go ahead and add this into your has map inside of your schema. You can share this link. But let me move into the next tip. The next Google My Business SEO tip is going to be, how do I find my leading competitors' categories? So let's say that you are an SEO consultant, much like myself. Let's say that Chris Palmer Marketing, that's me, this is your leading competitor. Let's start from the very beginning. So we're going to start at the very beginning. We're on Google. You're going to type in your leading competition. So let's just say it's Chris Palmer Marketing. Let's say that I'm your main competitor. Once brought to this particular page, again, you will go to Google Maps. You'll bring up the panel from the business, your competitor. And what you're going to see underneath the reviews is the top category or the primary category for this business. Once you have the primary category, you will want to highlight it and then copy it. And then to this right-hand side, you'll right-click and you're going to view page source again. Now, if you're utilizing Google Chrome like I am, what you'll want to do is go ahead and click on Line Wrap, and you will hit Control F yet again to find a particular element, and all you need to do is paste in that primary category, and once you take a look up here at the primary category, it'll highlight where the instances of the primary category are repeated within the page source. And all we have to do is just go look through this. And as you can see, the third one down is then going to give you my secondary categories. So here's internet marketing. It's highlighted because I'm finding it. And then as you can see here, right next to it is my secondary category, which is marketing consultant. So this is how you will find your top competitors' categories. Now again, if you're competing in a particular niche or for a particular SERP, you want to match and mirror your competitors in order to be able to dominate a particular SERP. So this is how you will find your competitors' secondary categories. And let's go in and move to the very last tip. So far we have gone over how to find the CID. I've also given you a code on a code to get the machine-readable entity ID. I shared with you a tool, also how to find your competitors' categories. And last but not least, if you don't know already, I'm going to share with you on how to get your place ID. So this is going to be Google Place ID Finder. And what you're going to find is there's an actual tool within the developer's tool. It's going to showcase a map. And all you have to do is type in your business. So for me, it's Chris Palmer Marketing. Okay. And then once you have Chris Palmer Marketing, it's going to issue me my place ID. So right on Google Maps platform, that's developers.google.com/maps/documentation. It's all right here. It's quite a long URL. This is how you'll find your place ID. You can also find your competitor's place ID. Again, these machine codes are great for machine code stringing. This is good for sending traffic through. This is good for sending links to. These links are very good to have within the site for authority outbound links. So I just wanted to go ahead and share that with you. And then last but not least, what I want to go ahead and give to you now is going to be another way to, or another element that you might want to add into your maps or your places as another tip and or trick, is let's take a look at our state. So I'm in Pennsylvania, okay? So once you're in Pennsylvania, what you're going to find is they actually have their own knowledge panel. Each state has it, so do cities and towns. So this is great to encompass inside of your schema. And let me go ahead and mention or showcase what I mean by this. So if we come over here to maps, and you type in Pennsylvania, as you can see here, there's share links, there's embeds, right? And more notably, if we take a look here, we right click and we go to view page source, we hit control F, okay, we'll do /G/. It's P. These are the place IDs, okay? I put G on my mistake, it's P. We're looking for the place IDs of the actual state or city, or if you have a service area business, you might want to collect these, all right? So these are the tips and tricks for Google My Business, Google Maps. I hope that you've enjoyed this tutorial, the tools that I've shared. My name is Christopher Palmer. If you have any further questions related to Google My Business, Google Maps, SEO, local SEO, really anything, search engine optimization, Google My Business, Google Maps, affiliate, anything at all, always feel free. Go ahead and ask in the comments below, and I always look forward to seeing you in the next Google My Business Tips and Tricks video. Have a wonderful day.